It's actually coming together. It's actually happening. What I've been talking about in my videos previously, and to see it actually unfold in front of us is pretty amazing, because we wish to God that it's not going to happen, but we know deep down inside that it is. There's a lot of things that I've spoke about in the past that seem to be coming true, and I wonder why. It's just the fact that we're able to foresee the trends in what the government's doing. And the problem with people is that they don't want to do that because they're so tied into the news channels.
Bearing of biased and false news
has become all too common on social media.
This weekend, the online site Deadspin created this compilation of dozens of Sinclair's local newscasters recording an identical promo accusing the national media of spreading fake news.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
And the bullshit that everybody's feeding us. You need to understand the person that you're dealing with. You are not understanding the government. You don't know who the government is. You don't know what agenda they have and why they have it. You don't know what their beliefs are, and you don't know what association they have with the big organizations. This is why people are lost and they think everything's a conspiracy theory, because the level of understanding, the education that we have is nothing. Educate yourself a little bit so you understand. I've made videos on vaccines. It's happening. Exemptions are no longer going to be there for those that, you know, claim religious exemptions. That one's gone. Philosophical? We ain't having that either. So there's not really much left but to roll up your sleeves and hit yourself with some vaccines. Now, what is actually unfolding is something that we're not used to. Something that until today, until they announce it, it's going to be something that's still a conspiracy. Hold this thought very strongly, because this is happening. The government has made it very clear that nothing is going to stop this plan. A committee member from the Liberal Party of Canada has recently spoke out about a complete world lockdown, a mandatory vaccine, and a bunch of more shit that's about to happen in the next 30 days. The government has made it very clear that this is going to roll out whether we like it or not. We have no say in what's about to happen. If you thought the first lockdown was hard, well, phase two lockdowns, complete shutdown. They're rushing to construct isolation facilities across all of the provinces and cities. And this is going to be taking place in December 2020. How do you plan something like this? This shit's been planned out for such a long time. They have it by the date. By the end of November 2020, an increase in COVID cases beyond the capability or the capacity of testing. So COVID-related deaths are going to increase. Prediction? No. This is written down. This is what they have planned out. A much more strict secondary lockdown. By February 2021, COVID-19 transforms into a new disease. COVID-21 is what it's going to be called. And now we're going to have COVID-19 and COVID-21 to worry about. It's scarcity. We bought the first sales package that they had. So now they're going to upsell us on COVID-21. And they're going to work synergetically together. Not only do we have COVID-19, but now we got COVID-21 to worry about. Medical care facilities will be overwhelmed with the new supposed cases of COVID-19 and COVID-21 related to deaths. Not going to be able to keep up. This is going to be expected in the first quarter and second quarter of 2021. Now, guess what? You thought that was it? Well, there's more. A third and final enhanced and enforced lockdown. Full travel restrictions will be imposed, not just in provinces, but in cities as of the second quarter of 2021. All right, hold on tight, because it's about to get serious. A program called the Universal Basic Income Program will be starting on the second quarter of 2021. July of 2021, the military personnel will be taking over the majority of downtown metropolitan areas, in not just in Canada, but in all over the world. Essential travel and checkpoints are going to be created. This will impose strict level of movement anywhere. We're talking about Palestine here. So in order to offset the government's claims to be an economic collapse on an international scale, the federal government is coming up with a so-called Canadian total debt relief bullshit plan that they have. It's like signing a deal with the devil. You sign this program, guess what's going to happen? God help us all. So in exchange for acceptance of this new total debt forgiveness program, you would have to forfeit ownership of your properties. That would be your home and any asset that you have. We would also have to agree to partake in the COVID-19, COVID-21 vaccine schedule, which would provide individuals with unrestricted travel. So now they restricted you, but if you take the vaccines, give away everything that you own, you're free to travel now. But then you ask, who are we signing all our properties to? The World Debt Reset Program will handle all the details. You don't worry, it's all theirs. Meaning, don't ask any questions. They're going to take ownership of everything that you own. Mandatory isolation in camps if you don't. Cannot travel, cannot leave the camps unless you take your vaccines. If you refuse to take this shit, they will be under strict restrictions. Cannot leave nowhere. Oh, you thought we were done. Oh, we're not even done yet. If you refuse to participate, you are deemed a public safety risk, put into isolation facilities. Once you are in these facilities, you have two options: to participate in the debt forgiveness program, roll up your sleeves and take the vaccines, or stay indefinitely in these facilities under classifications of serious public health risks and have all your assets seized. So you either give it away or they take it away. So here's a video that was set out in October with a member of the Canadian Parliament asking if the people of Ontario should prepare for camps. The answer was yes.
The member for Lanark, Frontenac, Kingston.
Thank you, Speaker. My question is to the Premier. In my supplemental question yesterday, I asked this government if the people of Ontario should prepare for internment camps. In September, the federal government posted a call for expressions of interest for contractors to supply, provide, and manage quarantine isolation camps throughout every province and every territory in Canada. These quarantine isolation camps, however, are not limited to people with COVID, but provide a wide latitude for many people to be detained. Surely this government is aware of the intentions to build these isolation camps from coast to coast. And my question to the Premier is, how many of these camps will be built, and how many people does this government expect to detain?
Question. Government House Leader.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It is very true that when people leave the country and when they come back in, that the province is suggesting, and the federal government, in cooperation with the federal government, we are suggesting that people isolate themselves. That has been a practice that has been very successful, not only here in the province of Ontario, but across Canada. And we will, of course, be redoubling our efforts to make sure that the people of the province of Ontario remain safe, Mr. Speaker. So if the member is referring to the fact that that one of the public health policies is that when you return from a jurisdiction outside of the province of Ontario or from another country, that you isolate yourself for 2 weeks. I would suggest that has been a good policy that has been working. In fact, this House has been doing the same thing since we came back. We are working in cohorts to make sure that the Legislative Assembly can continue to operate. That's why we have two separate cohorts, Mr. Speaker.
Response.
And with the cooperation of the official opposition, that is why all members of the Independents have been excluded from that cohort, because we want them to be able to participate in debate. So we will continue to do everything in our power to make sure that this House continues, but that the people of the province of Ontario and Canada are kept safe.
Supplementary question.
Again, back to the Premier. Here's the RFP, and in the RFP, it uses clear language to express that these camps can be used for a broad spectrum of people, not limited to travelers. Indeed, it doesn't even mention international travelers. It's just a broad latitude of people. And I'll send over the copy of the RFP after. So your government must be in negotiations and aware of these plans to potentially detain and isolate citizens and residents of our country and our province. So, Speaker, to the Premier, where will these camps be built? How many people will be detained? And for what reasons?
Question.
For what reasons can people be kept in these isolation camps?
You know what? This is the first time in my life I really hope that I'm wrong. I really do. If I could look back at this video in the future and say, you know what, you were absolutely wrong, I'm actually going to be very happy. This is how the government looks at it. This is not a 100-meter sprint. This is a marathon. But at the end of the marathon, there's a line that you cross for you to say that you've accomplished running the marathon. It doesn't matter how you run the marathon, how you cross the line, if you cut through the grass, if you go through the mountains, if you take a helicopter there, it's easy to predict because we know that there's an agenda and there's a line that needs to be crossed. How they do it, through vaccines, through restricted travel, through whatever way they want to do it. The agenda is to decrease population. The agenda is full control through the monetary system. By the end line that we need to cross is full control over a smaller population, meaning they got to decrease population. How they do it is up to them. Full control, how they do it is up to them. What is now happening and what we are speaking of is how they are going to get us across the line. And they are brilliant. They've planned this out for years. This is no joke. Now we just got to enjoy the ride because we set this shit up for ourselves. It's probably a good time to get in tune with the essence of where you are from. The creator, if you don't believe in one. This is probably a good time to start looking into it. We are not going to be here for long. And this looks like the beginning of the end for everybody. So if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Share the video if you find it beneficial. And if you didn't, oh well.